It's Sunny and Finn's Wrestling and Video Game Podcast. This week we discuss the games of October, we get hyped for PlayStation VR, and we give our predictions for WWE No Mercy.
What is up, guys? Welcome to episode 33 of the Sunny and Finn Show. I'm Sunny, and with me, as always, is Finn Steele.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm very good, thank you. How are you?
I'm at 98% now.
Good. Getting better.
I think I'm running at quite a decent level.
Excellent.
So I've got a bit of a tickly cough, but otherwise I'm doing pretty good.
Good stuff.
Yeah.
Awesome.
We've got some stuff to discuss this week.
We do.
I want to talk about PlayStation VR, because we're only sort of just over a week away now.
Exciting.
No Mercy is this coming Sunday, so we'll talk about that as well.
Yes.
No Mercy.
And that's the song, isn't it?
It is, yeah. Got in my head.
Well, I like how they've sort of just dug up that song from somewhere.
Yeah,
it's just random song. Especially made. I think they've just sort of found it.
Yeah, just going like SoundCloud, touch in No Mercy.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a song about
it. Oh, that'll do. Let's listen to it. Yeah. I'm looking forward to the pay-per-view. But,
me too.
We'll go into that a bit later on.
Yeah, okay.
But we might as well start, as we always start. What have you been playing this week?
Ooh, I'm playing a lot, actually. I've been off this week, so lots of gaming time. Just started, turned back into Fallout 4, going through the DLC. I've done the Automatron robot stuff. I'm just about halfway through the Far Harbor stuff, which has been really fun. Also played some WWF SmackDown Just Bring It last night on stream.
Yeah, very good stream as well.
Thank you very much.
Nice to see our community turning up for it again, as always.
Thanks to everyone for turning up. That was awesome. What else have I played? Played a little bit more Forza. Honestly, I still can't get into it properly. I don't know what's wrong with it. I should love it. I still love this game, but I don't know what it is.
I owe you an apology, actually, to be honest.
Okay.
Because I had a go at you last week about Forza, but then sort of the more I thought about it, it's like, it's just his opinion of it.
Yeah.
Like, I can't be mad at him for his opinion.
It's true.
So I apologise for my rant at you last week.
Apology accepted, thank you.
I have played a bit more Forza. I do love it, but I mean, I love the other ones as well, so
yeah.
It is sort of my thing, and I also love Need for Speed and The Crew. I can sort of appreciate that it can be maybe long-winded, because there is a shitload of stuff on the map. And the drive between sites is quite vast.
Yeah.
And if it's something that you're not really used to, or you don't find you have the time for, or you find it a bit boring, I can see why it wouldn't be for you.
Yeah. I think it's because I'm just not a car person. It's like, it's very focused on the cars and like the differences between the cars. And to me, as someone who doesn't know that much about cars, it's like all cars kind of feel the same.
That is fair enough.
Like I'm driving an Audi 1 minute and driving a Peugeot next. I can't tell the difference.
That's fair enough.
It's like, yeah, I think it's just like a Forza thing. I've never know. I've tried to get into like Forza Motorsport games. I've never like super liked them too much.
Okay.
So yeah, it's probably one I'm going to trade in at some point.
Fair enough.
Sadly. But other than that, what else have we played? Probably going to pick up something else, but I've forgotten it. Whatever. Lots of stuff. How about you?
Okay. I've been playing a lot of FIFA.
Nice. FIFA.
So FIFA 17 dropped last week. I didn't like the demo. I didn't have a high impression of the demo. I didn't think much to it at all. In fact, I thought the demo build was terrible.
Really?
Not good. To the point where it really dampened my excitement for the full release.
Yeah.
But the full release is now out, and I think it's excellent. I think it's really, really good.
Awesome.
I've been playing a lot of it. I've been playing the journey mode, which is like the new story mode that's in the game.
Oh yeah. Oh, the story mode. Yeah.
I think that is okay. I think it can be better.
Yeah.
I like the idea of it. But I don't like the idea that you're sort of a set character. I think it would be better if you could make your own character and pick your voice and all that sort of stuff, and then go through the story as a character that you've created, as opposed to this fictional character that they've made for you, Alex Hunter, who you really have you don't care for him, because
he's not you.
You know, you're made to be him. So,
yeah, exactly.
The rest of it though is great. Ultimate Team is still brilliant. Online play is seamless and really, really good. I've not tried the career mode out yet. At least not on the PS4 version. I did on Xbox One. Same as it always is. It's great. But I think as a whole experience, the game is very, very good.
Cool.
And I'm very impressed with it.
Awesome. I just remember the other thing I played. It's Dragon Quest Builders demo.
I noticed that you played that. Did you like it?
Yeah, it's awesome. I wasn't expecting too much, because I'm not a big fan of Minecraft. And this is basically Japanese Minecraft with Dragon Quest.
Okay.
But it's basically Minecraft, if Minecraft was more of an actual game. Like, there's things to do, there's things to progress to, there's a story to it. It's like, it's something fun, so cute and adorable. I love that kind of stuff.
Okay.
So, I'm a sucker for that kind of stuff, so yeah, definitely want to add to my buy list.
It's out really soon too, isn't it? Is it like next week? Or the week after?
Yeah, one of those. Next week or week after, I'm not entirely sure, but yeah, soon. I'm looking forward to it.
Fair enough. I've been playing a lot of NBA 2K as well.
Oh yeah.
I think the reason I've sort of drawn comparisons, I've drawn criticism of the journey is because the career mode in NBA is like a story-based thing, and you do create your own person, playing as yourself or whatever. The game's outstanding. I can't talk about it enough, but played a bit more Forza, but I played the demo for Outlast 2. Mm. I've only just recently played through the first one fully.
Yeah.
Because I was too scared to play through it, and I realised that it actually isn't as scary as I thought it was.
Yeah, it's and a few I loved jump it. Scares, but...
But, yeah, the second one's great. More of the same thing, same premise with, lifting your camera up to record stuff and using the night vision. Excuse me. And, it's good. Completely different setting. Yeah. You're like, at least in the demo, because the protagonist dies at the end of the demo.
Oh, yeah. So, I noticed you were outside. It's the last time you're, like, inside a...
Yeah.
Building, you think.
You're outside a lot. You do go indoors into like what looks like a school, I think. I'm not 100% sure, but
a building.
I think it is a school. I think it's weird because you're sort of in a vent that you get. It's fucking weird. It really is. Like, you go to a well.
Yeah.
And you look. Investigate the well. It's like, all right.
Sweet.
I know what's coming here.
Yeah.
Big things, like big tentacle things, come out of the well and drag you into like a vent.
I've seen enough hentai to know where this is going.
It didn't go that way.
Oh, okay.
Now they'll push you in a vent, and then the vent falls, and then you're in like a classroom.
Oh, yeah.
And the tentacles don't reappear until a little bit later on, but that doesn't happen still.
Oh, okay.
Okay. it was really good. It was bizarre, and it was another Outlast.
Sweet.
I'm going to get the full game. I think it looks pretty cool, so
yeah.
I'm excited for it.
One for Halloween coming up soon.
Yeah, I don't know when the full game's out. I didn't actually know. I knew there was a second one, but I didn't know that it was sort of demo close.
I think it might be Halloween, actually. I might have a look.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, fair enough.
Let's have a look.
But other than that, no, I've been pretty much exclusive to FIFA this week, really.
Cool.
Dipping in and out of Black Ops 3.
Yeah.
That's pretty much about it.
Nice. Good stuff.
So like we mentioned earlier on, we are now a week away from PlayStation VR.
We are.
And I wanted to sort of talk about our expectations for it. Because we are day one adopters of this brand new hardware.
Yep, yep.
And it's something that we've both been very excited for now for quite a while, since sort of it was announced for pre-order. Because before... I don't think the hype was really there, and we weren't sure whether we were going to get it or not.
Yeah, it's
but it went up for pre-order, and there we were pre-ordering
for first day one. Into that hype tornado once again.
Yep, the hype tornado got us once again. So, what are your expectations going in?
Every like preview I see of it, like people playing it, it looks like amazing. Everyone's super positive about it. Mm. I don't really know what to expect because I've never tried VR before. In fact, I'm probably going to like video myself the first time I try it. It's like YouTube or something. Just for fun. But yeah, I mean, you know what to expect. I'm hoping it's like probably like immersive and I'm like, my brain is tricked into thinking I'm actually there and all that.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I'm definitely looking forward to it. Looking forward to trying out the demos that come with it.
Yeah.
And yeah, I've heard good things about that Until Dawn game. so I'm probably going to try that. It looks fun. I like my kind of thing. Just like an on-rail shooter.
Cheap as well.
Yeah, pretty cheap.
$15.99.
Yeah, bargain. But yeah, it's hard to know what to think, what to expect, having never tried it before.
I agree. I mean, it's obviously going to change the way we look at games.
Potentially, yeah.
I mean, obviously it's a brand new way to play games.
Yeah, yeah.
I've never tried it before either. I mean, I know there's some stuff out there. You've got the Vive and, Oculus, is it? Oculus Rift?
Yeah, you've got Oculus Rift. You've got loads of, like, phone stuff. You, like, strap your face
to. Yeah, so, I mean, I've never tried it before and I'm super intrigued more than anything.
Yeah, same here.
My expectations are sort of, well, that's the thing. I don't know what to expect.
Yeah.
Like, I'm really excited for it. I want, like you, I want that immersive sort of experience.
Mm.
Like the game I pre-ordered, I pre-ordered Batman VR. And you know, I want to be Batman.
Yeah.
Like, and I know that it's not going to be like Arkham Knight and stuff like that where you're beating people up and stuff. I know it's a, like a murder mystery type game.
Yeah, sure.
But you use obviously Batman's tech and all that sort of stuff and it just sounds super cool.
It does.
I just want that immersive experience. I know that it's not going to be sort of 4K crystal
yeah, it doesn't
clear
need to...
sort of thing, but I don't think it needs to be that.
No, I don't think so.
Because I've seen some VR stuff, like with people using the Samsung phone one and that sort of thing.
Yeah.
Where it like it literally looks like a mobile phone game, but people are still seriously into it. Like still immersed, like they're there.
Yeah, exactly.
So I mean if they can get that out of a mobile phone, what are you gonna be able to get out of a PlayStation 4?
Exactly,
so
yeah,
Batman I'm super excited for and I've pre ordered it. I thought I pre ordered Until Dawn, but I was on the PlayStation store earlier on and I haven't.
Oh, right, okay.
So I think I will go for that one as well. Job Simulator looks pretty cool.
It does, doesn't it?
I don't think we're getting it straight away, though. I know it's coming to America, like, day one release, but it's not on the PlayStation Store.
Right, okay.
At least here, but I don't know if we've got to wait for it or what, but
probably.
I hope not.
Yeah, it looks fun. I'll give it a try, for sure. I've seen lots of awesome people playing it on YouTube, on, like, Live and stuff.
Yeah.
So, definitely try it out.
It's supposed to be really, really fun.
Yeah, it looks it.
There's, like, some big... There's some, like... £50 games, like, so they, you would expect they're in, like, sort of, like, the AAA space.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, Eve Valkyrie.
Oh, yeah. Interesting.
Which is, like, a dogfighting, spaceship simulator, I guess.
Mm.
And it looks really cool.
Yeah.
But for £55, you want a deep experience for that.
For sure, yeah. And that Riggs game as well is, like, £50. The multiplayer shooter.
I watched the trailer for Riggs, actually, earlier on today. And it looked really good. I'm going to hold off on it.
Same.
For now, because I want to see how I react to VR.
Yeah, exactly.
Because if I can't handle sort of the fast moving stuff, I mean, Riggs is that. It looks like
so
it's
fast.
All out sort of action. I don't know how it works because obviously if you're using move controllers.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know if you move it using the move controllers or you move it using your head or.
I think you aim with your head. You're holding just like a normal PS4 controller. And just like aim with your head and pull the trigger to shoot and stuff. It's like.
Yeah, it looks crazy. Obviously, a DualShock game, not a move game. Because that would make more sense, actually.
I think it is, yeah. I think you move with like the sticks and then you look and aim with your face. It's weird.
So your head's effectively acting as the right stick.
Pretty much, yeah. Seems that way.
I mean, it's
good taste to get used to.
It looks so good.
It does.
Like, Riggs looks really cool, but I'm gonna hold off on it. I'm going to see. Because Drive Club VR is on the demo disc.
Yeah.
So I'm going to try Drive Club VR, see how I sort of get on with that.
Good plan.
And go from there.
Yeah, good idea. I'm looking forward to, like, because there's a bunch of stuff that's getting VR stuff as well as normal games. Like, Tomb Raider's going to have a VR mission. Final Fantasy 15 is going to have something VR related.
Yeah.
Resident Evil 7.
You can play the whole game, Resident Evil 7.
Yeah, yeah. I'm looking forward to that, actually. It's, should be a good one. But yeah, lots of, just, I don't know. There's lots of stuff to try. We need to try it first before we know what's to experiment, I think.
Yeah, and what we're going to do, we're going to record our podcast later next week. We're going to record it on Thursday because by then we will have our VR units and we're going to sort of, we'll be able to sort of at least talk about it properly then.
Yeah, yeah.
Give our reactions to it as opposed to our expectations like we're doing now. I mean, PlayStation VR Worlds interest me, which I think they're more sort of four or five, I can't remember.
Yeah.
Sort of separate experiences, different things.
A little tech demo kind of things, yeah.
Like Street Luge, which looks crazy.
Yeah.
Also, the London Heist thing is what I'm most excited about for that, because it looks like it's going to be awesome.
It does. It looks fun.
Set in that sort of Getaway universe, which I love, the Getaway.
Yeah.
I wish they'd bring it back.
One day.
Maybe.
Maybe it's like a PS2 classic kind of thing.
Yeah, but it looks so terrible now.
Yeah,
but it didn't, like, when I think back to the Getaway, like, I thought it was awesome, but, like, London looks like a cardboard town in the Getaway.
Yeah, could be any town really, couldn't it? It's London accents.
Yeah, it's just got, like, red phone boxes and black cabs. It is this, oh, it's London.
Yeah, yeah.
Big Ben in the background somewhere. Cardboard Big Ben. Cardboard Ben. But that looks really cool. So it's difficult. I mean, what are you? Are you sort of getting anything early doors with it, like, day one?
Definitely getting the Until Dawn thing. That just looks like... on the fun. I don't know. I'd say I'm going to try the demos first. I'll see how I'm going with the demos. I'll play Until Dawn, Witcher Blood, and see how I get on from there, really.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can try Batman here.
Yeah, I'll try
Batman. I mean, Batman's sort of going to be my day one.
Cool. Yeah, I'll try Batman with yours. I think it's only like an hour long anyway, so.
Yeah, it's like a 60 minute. I know after you've done it once, you can go back and you can just like riddle of stuff to do.
Oh yeah, that's cool.
So okay. There's the side bits to do. I mean, it's only like I imagine the whole thing's for like 2 or 3 hours at most.
Yeah.
It's 100% the game, get all the trophies. There's no platinum.
Yeah, I've noticed that. Shame.
One thing that I have heard is with the trophies, they don't pop.
Oh, so yeah, that'd be weird in your head, isn't it? Yeah.
They ring in your ear.
Yeah.
Like, so you can hear the pop, you know, the noise the trophy makes.
Yeah, yeah. I know it
will. You'll be able to hear that, but you won't see anything on the screen, because I guess they've not figured out a way to integrate the trophy popping with VR.
Yeah, it just comes right in your face. Trophy! My eyes.
Yeah, so at least there's trophies there. I mean, I'm sure at some point they'll redesign it and you will be able to see the trophies popping in some way. Yeah. Even if it's just in the corner or something, I don't know.
Yeah.
But, I'm super excited. Like, I know we've said it a lot, sort of on podcasts over the last couple of months and stuff, but it's, you know, we are 8 days from it now.
Yeah, so close.
And taste it. It's just a really exciting time to be a gamer, I think, because this is a whole new way of playing, and it's a whole new system, and it's something to get really excited about.
Yeah, things are changing, and hopefully for the better.
And we might sit here next week and say that we hate it. I don't think we will.
Yeah, we could. Yeah. It's one of those things where it could be this, like, the next big thing, or it could just be like a gimmicky thing that we'll forget in a few years, like 3D TVs and like motion controls.
Yeah, sure. I mean, I adopted PlayStation Move on day one. And for the most part, I enjoyed it. Sports Champions, like we've talked about.
Yeah,
it
was great. And
there was it's
good tech.
The thing with it was, it wasn't unique because the Wii was already out.
Mm.
So obviously what they tried to do is capitalize on that success. Well, now, whereas this is something completely different. There is VR out there,
but it's
not as mainstream as this. This is PlayStation.
One.
I mean, this is as mainstream as gaming as you get.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, this is the first one people can actually like afford. The other ones are like super high end. Need a really super powerful computer to play it. Like, this is for like people like us who just care about the games and want something new.
This is for gamers.
For sure.
For the players. Don't get me wrong, if you are a casual gamer, you play Call of Duty and you play FIFA and stuff, you know, which there's nothing wrong with it.
No.
You know, you're still gaming, and if you're a casual gamer like that, this isn't something you should buy now.
No, probably not.
Because this isn't for you. This is for people like Finn and myself and, you know, I don't want to call us hardcore, but
hardcore.
We are sort gamers, of that. We are
MLG Pro.
We are gamers.
Right? Yeah, we game. It's our
we
passion.
Play games every single day and have done for many, many years.
Yeah, it's like our main hobby. It's our thing.
Yeah, that's it. We play games every single day. So this is why we are adopting this technology early.
Yeah.
I mean, I do believe in this technology. I really do. I think it's going to be superb.
I agree.
It's going to be like, I mean, what we need to do is forget the way that we play games now going into this. Because I don't think we're going to sort of put that demo on next week, like for Drive Club VR or whatever, and be driving like normal Drive Club. I don't think it's going to be like that. I think it's just going to be a whole new learning curve of gaming.
So. For sure, yeah. But I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be good.
Yeah, so the next episode, you know, you'll be able to hear our reactions and, you know, that's if we're, you know, not dizzy and shit from playing VR.
Puking in the corner.
Yeah. But like, we're groggy as hell after playing VR. We're like sitting here like, yeah, it was good, but oh my God. I'm super, like, let's just make it a 10-minute podcast and then just call it a day.
The room is spinning. But,
it's a really exciting time. And, you know, I'm going to decide in the next few days what else I'm going to pre-order. Cause the reviews are live now for most of the stuff. E-Valkyrie and Riggs, the embargo hasn't lifted for those yet.
Fair play. They're bigger games, that's fine.
Yeah, so I mean, I'm gonna make a decision. Well, I think the demo is gonna help a lot as well.
Yeah, for sure. That's what I'm waiting for. Just the demo, see how we're getting with it.
To me, Batman's not a game, it's an experience.
Exactly, yeah.
Rush of Blood isn't gonna be very long.
No.
But you know, I mean, Drive Club VR sounds like a real meaty experience.
It does, doesn't it? Yeah. I'm excited for that one. Even though I'm not a big fan of like cars and stuff, I was just saying, but the feeling of actually like, being in a car and driving and looking around is a good one.
Drive Club VR is a really interesting one to me, because the studio that made Drive Club isn't even a thing anymore.
Yeah, it's weird.
So I don't know who's even made this or who's going to support it.
A phantom developer, yeah. I guess it just handed it off to someone else and, hey, you guys.
I guess Sony own the IP Drive Club.
You must do, yeah.
But I mean, Drive Club is a stunning game.
Yeah, it's great.
Like, despite all of its early problems, it's turned out to be a fantastic racing game. But, I'm really intrigued by that one, because a lot of people have heaped high praise on it. So that's going to be a really interesting one.
Yes.
We'll know more next week, and you know, we'll talk about it in more depth next week. We just wanted to sort of talk about our expectations, what we're going to pre-order, and just, you know, generally share our excitement for it.
Yes. Hype.
Yeah. Super hyped.
Super duper hyped.
Super duper duper hyped. To infinity. And all them other immature things that we used to do on weekends. You got any gaming news this week? I couldn't really find anything of any worth to talk about, but I know that you may have a couple of bits.
It's been a slow news week again this week for gaming, other than VR, obviously. The thing I wanted to mention was Castlevania's 30th anniversary this year. You wouldn't know it listening to Konami, because they just kind of don't acknowledge it anymore for some reason. But yeah, I'm a big fan of Castlevania. I've got like all the old NES games. Like, I might play some on stream or something this month, since Konami not doing anything.
To celebrate its 30th anniversary.
Yeah, yeah. Because yeah, they're great games. They like pave the way forwards from the NES days. Castlevania: Symphony of the Night is one of the best games ever made, in my opinion.
Is that the PlayStation one?
Yes, yeah. PlayStation one, like Metroidvania one.
That is worth so much money. If you've got
it's crazy amount of money.
Intact, then that is worth a ton of money.
Yes, sell it on eBay or just give it to me.
Do you not have it?
I don't, sadly. I own only like Xbox 360 port of it.
Oh, okay. But,
yeah, it's a great game. Play it. Buy it.
A friend of mine had a copy of it recently that he sold on eBay.
Oh, yeah.
Like, nice. He had the, because you know, it came in one of them double cases that some PS1 games oddly came in.
Yeah.
They had like the disc in one and the book in another for no reason at all. But this one had like a music CD with it as well.
Oh, yeah.
And that's awesome. That one, if you have the music CD, which so unfortunately he didn't, it's worth just a shit ton of money.
Yeah, the music's great in that game as well. Oh, my goodness. And yeah, there's so many good Castlevania games on like DS as well. Oh, we're good.
Incredible to me that Konami don't acknowledge it.
I know, it's such stupid idiots. But, what's his name? Koji Igarashi? I think the creator of the Castlevania stuff, is making, Bloodstained: Ritual of the Night, which is on Kickstarter recently with Zybax. And yeah, that looks like classic Castlevania. I'm looking forward to that one.
Cool.
It's coming out next year, I think. So look forward to that. Screw Konami.
Yeah.
Yeah, other than that, gaming news, got PSX has been announced for December, which is like PlayStation Experience, I think.
They've announced that late this year, because usually sort of they announce it, I don't know, way in advance, but like it's like 2 months away.
Yeah, where is it this year? It's Cinemoga somewhere.
Oh, okay.
Shrug. But by then, PSVR will be out, PlayStation Pro will be out, all their big games will be out, so what's left to talk about? Like Horizon Zero Dawn, lots to probably talk about.
But I feel like with Horizon Zero Dawn, and I almost feel the same with Days Gone as well, and God of War, like that I'm already sold on those games. I don't feel like I feel like I've already seen enough of Horizon Zero Dawn to convince me that it's going to be awesome.
Yeah, same.
Like, so we don't need to keep seeing it. Like, the more I see, the more I'm going to be sick of it.
That's true.
It's like I'm hyped for Mafia this week, but I've hardly seen anything of it, and that's why I'm excited for it, because I've literally seen no gameplay. I've seen the trailers and a couple of screenshots. And I'm like, yeah, this looks awesome.
Yeah, this is good. There's no review copies there. That's a bit worrying, but
I do think it's to do with the day one patch, because I think sort of people, I've seen that some people, like online have sort of played it. It's a bit buggy, but I do think that is to do with a day one patch. I don't think 2K had put that out if it was crap.
Yeah. It's probably fine.
I have complete faith in it.
Yeah. It's fine. But yeah, they'll probably just announce some stuff from PSX. Not sure what. Maybe the Shenmue HD collection, which is definitely happening.
Oh man, that, you are never gonna get that game.
It's coming. It's coming, like March.
Didn't we say it had to be announced by the end of this year?
Yeah, has to be announced by the end of this year. This is my last chance, Sony. You've got to announce it. Please.
But you are right. There really is nothing to announce. I mean, I don't want to see more Horizon. I don't need to see Days Gone, because I think that already looks great.
Yep.
Spider-Man I'd like to see maybe a bit more of.
Yeah, sure.
But that's it. I mean, what are you going to announce?
It's a weird time to do it, isn't it? It's just before Christmas, so maybe that's like hyping up the stuff that's already out. Hey, look, buy our PlayStation Pro and Final Fantasy 15 and Last Guardian and stuff.
Yeah.
I don't know. Awesome. Who knows? But yeah, that's about it for gaming news, I think.
All right. So as this is the first podcast of October...
Yes.
Where's this year gone?
I know, right? It's so quick.
How long have we been doing this weekly now? Is this? 33, episode 33. So we've been doing it, because we were sort of stop-start at the beginning.
Yeah.
We were like, we started in December last year doing the podcast, but then we sort of you know, we weren't doing it weekly until...
Yeah.
When do you think it was? March or something, maybe?
I don't remember.
No, I don't either. We've been doing it weekly for ages. The time just seems to fly. This Wednesday comes around it so quick every week.
It does. Crazy.
It's my favourite hour and a half a week.
Yeah, same.
So it's a good time for the two of us to get together and talk about things that nobody else wants to talk to us about.
Yeah, pretty much.
The people in our lives just don't care about it.
Yeah, you talk to someone at work, it's like, oh, there's new games coming out. Oh, Pleasant VR, it's going to be cool. And it's like, cool.
Yeah. People might think I'm just a complete geek.
Yeah.
And I'm sure Lottie's probably sick of hearing about games and wrestling and stuff like that.
Yeah. I just wanted to share my excitement.
Yeah. Please be excited with me. But then you come here and it's like...
Yeah, video games.
Yeah, video games and wrestling. Ah! And it's a good time.
It is. So much fun. Yeah. First podcast was released 9 months ago, apparently.
9 months. So, what, February?
Sure.
Can't be right. Episode 1 was out in February. I'm sure we did it in December.
What did we talk about? We talked about TLC and NXT.
What, episode number 1?
Yeah. Was TLC, was that after... That was before the Royal Rumble, wasn't it?
Yeah, because, I mean, we did the Royal Rumble stream, didn't we?
Yeah.
We did a stream for that.
Yeah, it was before that. No, no, stupid SoundCloud.
Okay.
It doesn't know dates.
Okay, fair enough.
But, yeah, long time. Good, fun times. Awesome.
Yes. More fun times to come too. Loads more content.
Views.
It's just coming all the time. I mean, you know, where the YouTube channel's starting to pick up a little bit of steam now, it would seem.
Getting there.
Which is great. And we do appreciate all of you. I know we say it all the time, but we wouldn't say it if it wasn't true. You guys have been so awesome to us.
Yeah.
Since we sort of started doing this, back end of last year. And, we're going to continue to do it going forward because, what we do makes, you know, a group of people happy and that's good enough for us.
It makes us happy and that's all good.
Yeah. That's it.
Lots more reviews to come as well. Check out my reviews because they're really good.
Yeah, really, really good. The Toy Odyssey review is great. And
thank
the
you.
PES 2017 review that was written by myself and edited together by you is also great.
Yeah.
But there's lots of good stuff on there. And lots more stuff to come. So
We'll review PlayStation VR and we'll probably do 2K17 as well.
Yeah, we'll do WWE 2K17. Yeah.
Why the hell not?
Yeah, sure.
And
I only think it's fair that we review FIFA as well because PES, so.
We can do that, yeah.
Sure. Awesome. We'll capture some footage. I've got it on PS4, so.
Cool.
Okay. Let's talk about the game releases for October.
Yes.
And we can,
last track.
We can go through our excitement for, this is a busy month for games, like, seriously busy month.
Crazy busy. This month, next month is expensive. Right.
At least it's Christmas. That's my birthday next month. It's your birthday soon too, right?
Birthday in January.
Huh?
January, early January, 29th.
So I remember on one of the podcasts, or we were playing Rocket League, and you just dropped in there that it was your birthday.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes, my birthday, by the way. But January 9th, birthday. He wants to send me something.
Right, there you go.
I'm kidding, don't send me anything.
anyone's going to send you
anything. I know.
My birthday's November the 20th. You won't send me anything. That's fine.
I don't know.
I'm 32 this year.
God, you're old.
I am so old. I don't feel old. Like, sitting here with you makes me feel young.
Yeah. We're still kids at heart.
Yeah, literally.
Right, yeah.
Like, we're going to play Overcooked after we probably giggle like idiots, like, during it.
Yeah, I'm actually super looking forward to that as well. It's going to be so much fun. Anyway, October. Release dates. So, October the 4th, we have Warhammer End Times, Vermintide, which is like a Left 4 Dead thing. Came out on PC a while ago.
Right, what's that coming out?
PS4 and Xbox One.
So what is it, like Left 4 Dead?
Warhammer? Yeah.
That sounds fun.
It is. Looks fun. We should play it.
Okay.
I think it's out now, actually. What's it got? Rocksmith 2014 edition remastered. What, let's call it 2016 edition.
Sure.
It came on PS4, PC, and Xbox One. Mortal Kombat XL Combat Pack 2 is coming on PC.
Oh, okay. Oh, man, PC gets left behind on some stuff.
It does, doesn't it? Yeah.
Rightly so.
There's a game.
Don't play PC nerds.
God damn it. We have a game called Necropolis coming out, or is out on PS4 and Xbox One.
Necropolis? I think I've heard of that.
Hmm. So, yeah.
I don't know what it is, but I think I've heard of it. I've heard the name at least.
Yeah, it sounds familiar. Call of Duty Modern Warfare Remastered Campaign for pre-orders.
Full title. Yeah, it's out now.
It's out now.
I haven't pre-ordered it yet. I'm going to wait until, because I want to play multiplayer and you can't play multiplayer until it goes live. So.
Fair play.
I'm going to wait for that.
Mafia 3, which you just mentioned, comes out this week, October 7th.
Excited for it? Are you going to get it or are you waiting?
I'm going to wait for reviews. I'm holding off just in case.
Just in case it sucks?
Just in case it sucks, yeah.
Okay, wait for me to play it on Friday and then yeah. I'll text you and I'll tell you that it sucks. Just don't buy it.
Yes.
I'm sure it's going to be great. I'm really looking forward to it. Two was brilliant. Never played one, but I have absolute faith that this is going to be good.
I hope so. I hope you're right. The second one was great.
Yeah, second one's great.
Paper Mario Color Splash on Wii U on October 7th.
No one will buy it.
Probably not. It's on Wii U soon. Yeah. Suda 51's The Silver Case remaster on PC on October 7th. I love Suda 51, so that could be good.
Sure.
Well, then, 100-foot Robot Golf is coming on PlayStation VR on October 10th.
Oh, right. What? October 10th?
Yeah.
Right, the unit's not released until 3 days after that.
Oh, yeah. Weird. I guess you can play it without VR as well.
That's an interesting one. I know that that is coming out on day one because the trophies are there, so it must be done.
Yeah, that's true.
But that's not available to pre-order on PlayStation Store either.
Interesting.
So that is one I'm interested in as well because it just sounds fun.
It does, doesn't it? Big golf with robots and VR.
Yeah. It just sounds great.
Yeah. Gears of War 4 on PC and Xbox One. October
11th. Christ, yeah.
Yeah.
God, that's coming around so quick.
It has. We should do like a co-op campaign of that. That'd be fun.
Yeah, I need to get that. I'm probably going to wait till Christmas or my birthday for it, but yeah, I definitely want to get it.
Yep, same. Duke Nukem 3D 20th Anniversary World Tour on PS4, Xbox One, and PC.
Nope.
Yeah, same. Rise of the Tomb Raider 20-year celebration, October 11th. I'm looking forward to that one.
Yeah, that's. I mean, I have played through Rise of the Tomb Raider already on Xbox One, and cool. It is fantastic. I have no doubt that it's going to be even better on PS4 if it's. That's actually possible. Plus, it comes with VR stuff as well, yep. So that's cool.
Yeah, I think I pre-ordered it, actually, so yay. Also, another one I pre-ordered, WWE 2K17, finally.
Ooh, yeah! That comes out on Tuesday, so isn't it?
It does.
Jesus, Nick, like, I've got Mafia Friday, WWE on Tuesday, and then VR on Thursday. I mean, that is a busy week.
Yeah,
I'm super excited for 2K17 now. Yeah. I just need it in my life. Like, No Mercy is the last stream we have to do on Sunday with 2K16.
It is. Thank goodness.
I'm so happy about that.
Yeah, we just tune on day one as well. I'll come over and meet
you. Oh, for sure, yeah.
Are you off next week or are you still working?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, sweet. Me too. Awesome. Good times. So, also the same day, a game called Sunless Sea Submarina with a Z on PC. It's rogue. We have Batman Arkham VR, which you mentioned.
Yeah.
Metal Gear Solid 5, the Definitive Edition.
Oh, is that next week, is it?
That's the same, yep, same day as everything else.
That's a bad time to release it.
It's such a bad time.
Like, you're releasing it in between Mafia, which will sell, WWE, which will sell, and then VR. So people have bought VR, they're not going to touch Metal Gear Solid.
They're not. That's a terrible, terrible idea.
And I think most people who have bought Metal Gear, like, most people who wanted to play Metal Gear Solid will have already played it.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm not sure.
Yeah, I don't know who did it for.
This, because Ground Zeroes has been free on both consoles. So if you've missed out, then that's, you obviously didn't want it anyway.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a weird collection.
Christmas, mate.
Yeah, true. Oh no, Dragon Quest Builders comes out the same day. It's another one for me. Ooh, busy week.
Christmas.
Yeah, Christmas. Another one Christmas. Moto Racer 4 on PS4, Xbox One, and PC on October 13th. Same day as VR. Not going to play it. Star Wars Battlefront X-Wing VR Mission. PlayStation VR, that could be cool.
When's that out?
Apparently day one on VR.
Really?
Apparently so.
Right, okay. That will be cool.
Along with Drive Club VR, Until Dawn, Rush of Blood, Res Infinite, and that's it. Well, VR, apparently, what's this? So far?
No, because Riggs is out.
Yeah, that's true. It's a bad list. Bad list.
Wait, where have you had this list from?
It's VG247.
Let's see where I usually get my list from.
It was GameSpot last time, and they failed me as well, so it's good.
Yeah, see, GameSpot, I think, is where I usually get mine from.
Okay? Yeah, well, GameSpot sucks. GameSpot. I don't hate them, they're just... Views aren't very good.
Hang on. Oh, here we go. Let me have a look here. GameSpot. Do you want to read off this list instead?
Sure, go for it.
Where have we gotten to? October 13th. Right. Mm-hmm. Eve Valkyrie, Eve Gunjack. That's on PlayStation VR as well, so that's two separate games.
Right, okay.
Motor Racer 4, like you said, PlayStation VR itself, Res Infinite, Roller Coaster Dreams, which I haven't heard of, Thumper, for PlayStation 4, and I think there's PlayStation VR stuff for that as well. World War Toons on PlayStation 4.
Right.
Disney Magical World 2 on 3DS.
You're way more than I do.
There's a Skylanders coming out next week. Skylanders Imaginators on everything.
Nobody cares.
Eagle Flight on Rift. That's not coming out for a while on PS4.
December 20th, apparently.
December the 20th?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Exist Archive, The Other Side of the Sky for PS4 and Vita, October 19th. Battlefield 1, October 21st.
Yeah, yep, it's a good one, big one.
Civilization 6 on PC, October 21st.
Yep, yep.
Darksiders War Mastered Edition on everything, including Wii U and PC, October 25th.
Interesting.
Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2, mm-hmm. Xbox One, PS4, October 25th, with Farming Simulator. This list is out of date because it's got Last Guardian on that day as well.
Great.
World of Final Fantasy, October 25th, is that right?
Yep, yep. I've pre-ordered that one. That's going to be good.
That's a you game, isn't it?
Yes, a big me game, yes. Cutesy Final Fantasy crossover game. Stalled.
This is one people are excited for. Elder Scrolls 5 Skyrim Special Edition Remastered, October 28th. On Xbox One, PS4 and PC, that'll be huge.
Yep.
Titanfall 2, same day. And Yamwari Night Alone on Vita and PC, October 28th.
Right, okay. Also got Batman Return to Arkham this month as well, October 18th.
That's why are these lists so out of date and rubbish?
Yeah, they are a bit. Bit all over the place.
Yeah, Batman Arkham VR, not VR, sorry. Batman Arkham, I've just got VR on the brain.
Return to Arkham.
Return to Arkham, yeah. I'm excited for it, but I'm not day one in it.
Yeah, same.
I'm going
to
wait.
I want to play the first one. I'm not too worried about the other two, just want the first one.
But you only get one anyway. No, yeah. You only get two anyway.
One and two.
Yeah.
That's a good point, yeah.
Good investment. Nice, you should have bought it when it was cheap.
Yeah, yeah. I will. I'll get it eventually.
Because there's no sign of that Game of the Year edition that we thought was coming.
Weird. The one game, the one time they don't do it, it's the one time I actually wait for it.
Yeah, very strange. They should have just bundled them all together.
Would have made sense.
Yeah. Especially this time of year, people would have bought it.
Yeah.
I wouldn't have. I want Arkham Asylum and I want Arkham City.
Fair play. Oh, and Dark Souls 3 DLC comes out this month as well.
Yeah.
October 25th.
On it's only 12 quid.
Yeah, cheap one.
There is actually loads coming out this month, but these lists that we've got are actually terrible.
Yeah, a bit. Not the best.
Like especially the one that you were reading, didn't even have all the VR stuff on there.
Yeah. I don't know. Update your list, people.
Yeah, come on, guys. We're too lazy to compile our own list, so
yeah,
we're relying on you guys on the internet here to help us out a little bit, okay?
We've got a podcast, man.
Yeah. Okay, let's talk wrestling.
Okay.
So, No Mercy's this coming Sunday.
It is.
And we'll talk about that. Mm-hmm. But I watched Bound for Glory. Happened.
It actually happened. Oh, okay, good.
It was a good show.
Yeah?
It was okay. Again, with the Hardy stuff, I could really do without it.
Yeah, I did see that separately, actually, some of it. I was like,
what? It was just crazy.
Yeah, it's weird.
Production-wise, obviously, it's really well put together.
Yeah.
But to me, when I was watching it, it felt like it was pre-taped.
Oh, yeah.
So, obviously, Bound for Glory is taking place at, 8 o'clock at night in America.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, when Matt Hardy and Abyss are fighting outside, there was nobody around, hardly any cars to be seen. So, this has obviously been filmed another day.
Yeah.
Very early hours of the morning to make it seem like it was taking place outside, live, there and then.
Yeah, I think they started in the ring, didn't they? And then they, like, fought to the back and then it cut to the...
So, I mean, Jeff Hardy had two costume changes during the match.
That's a good point, yes, it must have been.
So, it was just, I don't know, it just seemed too obviously pre-taped to me. I mean, the in-ring stuff was great.
Yeah.
For the Great War. But, to me, that isn't professional wrestling.
No, it's a bit much.
Just a bit nonsensey. I could do without it. But the rest of the show was fine. I mean, Aaron Rex, or formerly Damian Sandow, who won the Grand Championship, which was cool, against Eddie Edwards because Drew Galloway was injured. But I rate Eddie Edwards very highly.
Cool.
And if the point system works how I think it works, I actually had Eddie Edwards winning.
Oh, right, okay.
Not Aaron Rex, but...
Interesting.
It is what it is. I'm not a good ringside of TNA.
Yeah.
But, it was a good show. It was cool to see Gail Kim get inducted into the TNA Hall of Fame, which Josh Matthews kept referring to as prestigious. I don't think anything in TNA is prestigious at the minute.
Yeah, I think Josh Matthews is terrible. It's a bad, bad announcer.
I do think Gail Kim deserves some recognition.
Oh, yeah.
I just think it's... having a Hall of Fame for TNA seems like a bit much to me. I don't know.
Yeah, it's like WWE does it, so let's do it as well. So, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, with WWE, it's got... a lot of lineage.
Exactly, yeah.
With TNA, it's like...
Been around for like a couple of years.
what are we into? Has it been just over 10 years TNA's been around?
Just about.
I don't think you can really sort of...
Not really, no. It's been longer than that.
Have a history. So it's like 10 years isn't history.
Not really.
Not really. You know what I mean? It's like 10 years ago, we were working at first assist.
Yeah, yeah, seriously. He's play call center.
Yeah. So he's like, that's, we're not in the first assist hall of fame.
We're not. I think first assist even exists anymore, does it?
I don't think so. No.
No, there you go. Just like TNA.
I mean,
sorry, TNA.
I don't know how they got, but I mean, the show overall, it was a good show. I do think it's good if they do somehow stay in business.
Oh yeah,
because you know it's nice to have an alternative to WWE. Oh, yeah, I am sure. Quite enjoying it at the minute.
Yeah,
but I don't know. I mean, the again, this is still rumors, and this is something that JR talks about on his podcast, that WWE is gonna buy some stake in the company for the tape library. Mm-hmm. Billy Corgan's gonna get the company. But he's going to have to rebrand because WWE will own TNA.
I see. Interesting. Okay.
I don't know. Again, this is just complete rumor. We have nothing more than we did last week when we talked about this.
Yeah, because, pretty much.
Dixie Carter, there was apparently like a locker room meeting after or before Battle for Glory, either or. You know, Dixie said that WWE isn't buying TNA.
Right.
Right. But I think buying the tape library and Billy Corgan getting the company and starting afresh are two completely different things.
Yeah, possibly.
We'll see. I mean, this is going to be an ongoing thing. I think they had money from an unknown source, quotes.
Right. They stole it.
To fund Bound for Glory, pay the talent and, you know, pay for the TV tapings that's going to take them up until whenever.
CastForGold.com.
Yeah, the training in the belts.
Yeah.
So we don't really know what's going on at the minute. I'm sure we will know more sooner rather than later, and we'll talk about it at that point.
Something's got to happen too.
Yeah, something's got to give with it. But for now, Bound for Glory was a good show. I'm going to watch Impact again this week because I am quite enjoying it at the minute, as it's cool. A nice alternative to WWE.
Yeah, I might give it a chance as well. Why not?
It has gotten better. I mean, yeah. There was a period when I just thought, I'm not watching this, it's garbage.
But, yeah.
There's some really good talent on there. So Mike Bennett and Maria are great. Aaron Rex is great. You got Galloway. EC3 is cool. Lashley. There's a lot of really good talent in there. It's cool. Just.
And Cody Rhodes just debuted on there, didn't he?
Yeah, Cody Rhodes debuted on there with his wife Brandy.
Awesome.
Formerly, can't remember her name.
The ring announcer lady. Yeah. Yeah. I know what you mean.
Yeah, she had a funny name, but I can't. WWE gave her a funny name.
Yeah. What was it?
No, I have no idea. I can't even remember.
Oh, God. It's on the tip of my tongue.
Yeah, same. But I can't remember what it is.
God damn it. Oh well, we'll think about later.
Yeah, but she's going to be an active wrestler as well, by the looks of it.
Cool.
They both came out in ring gear.
Yeah, that's interesting. I'm down with that. That's fine.
So it's worth watching. I mean, yeah. I think it'd be good for TNA if somebody does buy it and rebrands it. Like if Billy Corgan does get hold of it and then rebrands it into something else, I think that'd be much better for the company.
Yeah.
So if you can still have the title history, you can still carry the title holders over if you really have to. Or you can start completely afresh and WWE gets the tape library for us to all enjoy on the network.
Yeah, my best fine with me.
Either way, wrestling wins because there's still competition there and there's other wrestling there to be viewed. So, I mean, I support all wrestling.
Yep, all wrestling is good.
All wrestling is good.
Yes.
So, let's talk about this week in WWE now.
Eden Styles.
That's it.
Yeah.
No relation to Jerry.
Yeah.
Or AJ.
Yeah.
So let's talk about WWE this week.
Okay. It was good, I thought.
Yeah, another strong week, actually.
Yeah.
I enjoyed Raw.
It was good. We won't go down like match by match like we normally do, but just like go to the big points. Just a match with Roman and Rusev for US title in Hell in a Cell. That was announced.
Yeah.
Surprise, surprise.
Yeah, I'm not surprised that happened. What this needs to do, though, is end this feud completely.
Yeah, I agree.
Because I think it's been going on for a long time, even sort of before SummerSlam. So I think what needs to happen now is this Hell in a Cell match needs to end the feud. And I think they did sort of point to that.
Yeah.
Like Mick Foley wants to end to this feud and he's agreed to the match and blah, blah, blah. So, I'm fine with it. I mean, I thought, you know what? I've got to give credit to Lana here because, you know, she isn't Russian, obviously. CJ Parker is her real name, and she is very American.
Yeah, and she's just in a movie where has an American accent.
And on the WWE 24 Divas program that was on recently.
Oh yeah.
She spoke in her normal voice on that.
Right, okay.
Actually, I'm surprised that was allowed to be happening.
Yeah.
It is what it is. But I think she does a really fantastic job of not breaking accent during these really good promos that she does.
Yeah, yeah.
So fair play to her. But Rusev is great, super good heel. And I like this feud, but I want it to end.
Yeah, same. It's going on a bit while now. But,
and we just know who's coming out of it with that belt, and it's not Rusev.
Yeah, poor Rusev. Yeah. But yeah, hopefully everybody will get put into a new feud. Hopefully, maybe,
hopefully bigger and better things. I mean, hopefully. Rusev could go for the heavyweight title.
Yeah, I definitely agree. He's great. What else happened? Oh, a couple of awesome cruiserweight matches. The crowd was much better this week.
Yeah, I thought that. I'm glad the crowd were more receptive to TJ Perkins, and he fought Tony's.
He fought Brian Kendrick this week.
Of course he did, yeah.
And Kendrick won, which set up a match for No Mercy, probably. Or whatever the next, Hell in a Cell.
What went unnoticed, I think, here, especially by the crowd, and I think the commentator sort of understated it a bit as well, or undersold it, rather. Like, Brian Kendrick raked the eyes before he did the bully choke.
Oh, yeah, he did.
So he won by cheating, technically.
Pretty much.
But the commentators just didn't sell it at all.
Yeah, it's one of those things. He's supposed to notice it. To be tweeting out big things,
yeah.
I don't know.
But I thought it was a really good match. I thought both of them, TJ Perkins wowed the crowd. Brian Kendrick did his part by playing the heel.
Mm.
And I think the two of them gel so well in the ring together. You can tell they know each other, and it's a really promising feud. I think it's really good. I'm impressed.
Yeah, I like it. Good stuff. There's another one which was Rich Swann versus Tony Nese, which is another great match. Two amazing athletes.
Yeah.
Coming at it, basically.
Crowd's starting to get behind Rich Swann as well. I think, the more these people are going to be seen on TV, the more the crowd will get into it. Rich Swann is super likable.
Oh, yeah.
I'm a big Rich Swann fan. And, same goes for Tony Nese. I think, Tony Nese is really good as well. I mean,
yeah. He got like a big round of applause after some like awesome looking sequence he did.
But he's a freak of nature. He's like
yes.
He's just a complete freak.
It's amazing, yeah.
It's good to see these guys getting decent TV time, and it's good that people are getting to know them so that the crowd are going to sort of, you know, respond to them better, and that's only a good thing for Raw.
I agree.
And WWE in general. It's awesome to see these guys be integrated onto the main show.
Yep, definitely. What else do we have? Oh, we had an awesome tag match between A New Day and Jerry KO. Hilarious segment beforehand.
Yeah.
With her, amazing. Go watch it.
Yeah, it was really cool. New Day, we said that they need to sort of freshen up their act a little. Uh-huh. And although they haven't as such, it still felt, they're still very good.
I think they just gel so well with Jerry and Kevin Owens.
Yeah.
And the way they like reacted to getting put on Jericho's list was very funny.
Yeah, like they didn't want to get put on Jericho's list, like it was a really bad thing that was going to happen.
Yeah.
But I love that. And I love Jericho at the minute, and Jericho and Kevin Owens is really good together.
Oh, so good. They like tease like a little bit of dissensions, like, oh, we could go for tag titles, or I could go for your title. Ooh, possible. Yeah.
But I don't dissension. Think you can't turn Jericho face at the
minute. Not yet, no.
You just can't. He's just...
No. Just yeah, if he does give a title, it'd be some like triple threat or a four way kind of thing.
Yeah, but it was good match. Seth Rollins came down.
Yep, he did. He what happened there?
Seth Rollins distracted. Came to the top of the ramp, then he distracted Kevin Owens.
Oh, of course he did. Yeah. Then he gave a pedigree to Jericho after the match.
Mm-hmm. Quick side note here: I don't think Ashton Kutcher and Danny Masterson did a bad job on commentary. In truth.
Yeah, all right, yeah. That's surprisingly good.
Pointed out glaring thing that WWE never points out.
Oh, yeah, what's that?
Kevin Owens hasn't been tagged. What's he doing in the ring?
Oh, yeah, that's a good point.
The commentary never, ever alludes to this.
Yeah.
And yet Ashton Kutcher's sitting there going, well, he's not even been tagged in. What's he even doing in there?
Stop it with your logic.
Ashton, this is wrestling. We don't talk about logic. Yeah. Things happen. That's it. Just leave it as it is.
But no, I thought they did a fine job. Better than most spells, I guess, anyway.
Yeah, because they seem like they knew about the product.
Yeah.
Like, you know, when they had that backstage bit, like they interacted really well. And not awkwardly.
Yeah.
And it was like, okay, but that's fine. It's believable.
Yeah, it's fine. That's it.
Because you get some, and they're promoting some. I mean, they were promoting their Netflix show or whatever.
Yeah.
But they didn't shove it in your face. They exactly. didn't, at least. Michael Cole was like, so guys, tell us about your Netflix show. It's like, yeah, but Kevin Owens is in the ring and he hasn't been tagged in, so what's he even doing there?
So, yeah. It's like, oh, this is just like your new show that they're being on Netflix. It's like, no, it's not.
Nothing like it. Like, literally nothing like it.
Yeah. I don't know.
But still, it was fun. And it just builds the Seth Rollins and Kevin Owens feud up a little bit more.
It does.
Towards Hell in a Cell.
Good stuff. Well, we have another Cesaro and Sheamus match. They tag together versus some jobbers. And I like the little thing they've got going on. Like, trying to one-up each other. Like, desire to call jumping DDC off Sheamus' back. And, yeah, it's cool.
It's going to work.
I think it's going to work, yeah.
I do.
The two talented guys. And
Speaking of tag teams, the club are being built. I don't know if you noticed this or not.
Mm.
But they showed, like, a video package of them, like, sort of destroying people.
Oh, yeah.
And then, like, they built them up like they're going to be absolute destroyers and eventually go get the tag team titles.
Good.
But this is too late. Like, this should have happened before.
Yeah, definitely.
Like, you've done the comedy, you've made them lose twice, maybe even three times to the New Day,
mm-hmm.
and now you're building them up as unstoppable monsters who couldn't possibly win the tag team titles.
Yeah.
You've done it arse backwards.
A little bit. I hope it works. I hope they do, like, eventually get the tag team titles. But yeah, it's a bit late. WWE.
I do think they will, but I think Sheamus and Cesaro are going to win them first.
Yeah. Yeah, I think you're right. The club probably win it off them if they win it at all.
Yeah.
Yes. What else do we have? Oh, more story, another squash match against another awesome name jobber, Chase Silver.
Yeah, good Love name. It. Solid name.
Great name. After the match, he went on, had a pretty decent promo actually, saying he wants a real opponent for next week, or else there won't be it next week.
Ooh. Yeah, I don't know what he meant by that, but either way, that's fine.
I will end the world.
Who are they going to send out?
I don't know. Well, I guess Sin Cara didn't count as a real opponent.
But we all know in real life who would win that fight.
Oh, yeah, obviously Sin Cara would win.
Not Braun. He's the ultimate fighter, Sin Cara.
Of course.
Obviously win that fight.
It's the greatest fight that's ever lived.
Yeah.
I don't know, maybe the Big Show? Is he on War?
Oh, come on. It just seems too easy. Like, remember the show, Steve said ages ago that they were going to send Big Show down to fight Braun.
Yeah. But it's too obvious. It's too obvious not to happen, really, isn't it? Yeah, but I think they'll get into like a feud or anything. I think Braun will just squash him on Raw and then that'll be big sort of disappear back into the shadows or something.
He hasn't been in ages.
He hasn't.
Has he even been in it since the draft?
I don't know, to be honest. I don't think so. He might have come back randomly one time, just like a face, like, hi, I'm a big guy. Stupid smile on his face.
I think he'll be a big show, I do.
Yeah, it's gonna be, isn't it?
Or Mark Henry or someone like that.
Oh yeah, Mark Henry. One of those two. For sure.
Like a big guy who, you know, that can make Braun look good.
Yeah.
Although I think Braun's doing a really good job at the minute. I do.
Yeah, I think he's great. Titus O'Neil, that's a weird new gimmick.
What, the Titus brand?
Yeah.
He
lost as well to Sami Zayn. Weird.
I'm glad Sami, about.
Yeah, me too. Because Sami Zayn.
I was watching it and I was thinking, if Sami Zayn loses this, I'm going to be livid.
Yeah. Oh, God. And, anything else to talk about? Oh, Emma. Emma's coming back next week as Emma Lena. I hope they have something in mind with this. I hope it's not just like, oh wow, she turns out she's like really hot. Let's put her in bikinis and stuff.
But it sort of looks like it's leaning towards that because obviously it went through Emma's Instagram pictures of her looking like.
Vitus has gone through her Instagram thing and gone like, oh wow, Emma's, bikinis, let's change her name.
Yeah.
For a new gimmick.
It was a good impression. I'm impressed.
Thank you. I talk like this. No, I can't do it.
Is that your Vince McMahon impression?
I did attempt at it, yeah.
Okay. Well, I knew it was Vince McMahon.
Yeah, well, that's how he sounds, yeah.
Okay. I'll try
sometimes.
The end of the vignette sort of said, the evolution from Emma to Emmalina.
Yeah.
Did it say next week?
I think so. I think it was.
Jesus.
Emmalina's not a real name.
So is she fit to return? No pun intended.
Well, she's fit. But, yeah, I think she came back doing some live event, didn't she?
I've no idea. She was only refereeing, though.
Was she, huh?
Unless she's just going to be play the hot girl on TV for a little while.
Possibly. Mm. Well, it worked for Eva Marie. Where's she gone?
She was suspended, weren't she?
Sure, it's been 30 days by now.
I would have thought so. She'll be back.
I hope so. But yeah, other than that, the only other thing to talk about was the main events. The women's main events, first time in a long, long time. First time since Lish, Trish and Lita.
Lish and Trita.
Yeah, that's the one. But yeah, so Dana got beaten up by Bayley beforehand, which is what was funny.
Yeah.
And
she really lobbed her into that thing as well.
She did, yeah. But yeah, the match was amazing, I thought.
Superb. Yep. Absolutely outstanding.
So good. Both women were fantastic.
Must be honest, I'm surprised they took the belt off Charlotte this soon.
Yeah, honestly, I was impressed with both ladies, but I'm more impressed with Charlotte, especially after that crazy, awesome, spinning, flippy moonsault thing.
She's a ridiculous athlete.
She's crazy good, yeah.
She's something else. She really is. She really is outstanding. I think both, don't get me wrong, I think Sasha is amazing as well.
Oh yeah, she is.
But we've been really hyping and talking really highly of Charlotte these sort of past few weeks and this title run that she's currently been, that she's been having and how good it's been. And I would have been happy to see it go on a little bit longer.
Yeah, same. I expect it to, but.
Especially with all the talk, you know, like Forbes, there's that Forbes article saying that she's one of the greatest female superstars, if not the greatest of all time already.
Yeah.
And so I'm surprised they put the belt back on Sasha. Maybe this is sort of reverting back to original plans.
Maybe. I think that's probably a good
before
guess.
Before Sasha got injured.
It's good. Yeah.
But great to see the ladies in the spotlight. Really happy that they put on such a good show and, absolutely delighted for Sasha, of course.
Of course.
This feud's only going to carry on. That's only going to be a good thing. So,
yeah. Looking forward to seeing more.
A really good episode of Raw this week, I thought.
Excellent, yeah.
Enjoying the build to Hell in a Cell so far. I mean, what is it, a few weeks away?
Yeah, it's 2 weeks after. Yeah, 2 weeks after Sunday.
Yeah. So, yeah, this is good progress, I think.
Yeah, I agree.
Somebody asked us a question yesterday on the stream as to whether we thought WWE was better or worse since the brand split.
Oh, right, okay. And, missed that.
Yeah, it was Tyrone asked us on the stream yesterday.
Thank you, Tyrone.
I do think it is better now.
Yeah, I do. I agree.
I think, especially the last few weeks, I think SmackDown has really come into its own and it's been a really must-see show.
Yeah, I agree.
And Raw's getting, they're starting to get the formula correct now, I think, and how to work a 3-hour show properly.
Yeah, they're definitely a bit of a rough start, but I think they've got the hang of it a bit now.
I think they're definitely getting there because it just seemed to flow really well this week. It didn't feel like a 3-hour show, whereas before you're sort of sitting there and you're thinking, Jesus.
Yeah, exactly.
Is fully dragging, like how long of this is left, but it's not felt like that the last couple of weeks. It's actually been a really well paced show, and that's good going forward.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah, much better. Keep it up, WWE.
Yep.
We're fans of what you're doing. So yeah, that brings us to SmackDown.
Yeah,
which I watched earlier this morning.
The final SmackDown before No Mercy, which is this coming Sunday. And again, it was a good show. Final hype for No Mercy.
Yep.
No point in going through the matches. Let's just talk the key points.
Yep. Okay. So to start off the night, it was Bray versus Kane, during which Randy came on the Titantron to distract Bray. He's like, "Oh, come at me, bro!" And obviously Bray.
Yeah, it was upside down.
Yeah, that was weird.
Well, weird, but.
So yeah, that was a thing going through the night. At one point, Randy trapped him in like a box thing.
Yeah, it was like behind a steel shutter door.
Yeah, weird.
I think it's like one of them, you know, like on Storage Wars.
Oh yeah, like Storage Wars.
Like you open one of them, the thing, and the bloke talks really fast when they're bidding.
Yeah.
I think it's like a storage container sort of thing.
Yeah, I think you're probably right. But turns out Bray Wyatt is a wizard and can just teleport wherever he wants. So,
Sister Abigail helped him escape. So it was nice. It was really freaky, actually. It was a proper horror movie sort of thing.
Yeah, because Ray like kind of slowly starting to lose his mind a bit, getting crazy and crazier until, it's kind of disappeared.
Yeah. Usually I'm not into this sort of strangeness and this sort of over the top nonsense in wrestling. Like we talked about the Great War and it's fine, but it isn't pro wrestling, and I'm usually not into it. But this, you know, last week was cool when he was searching for him, when the tables were turned and Randy Orton was searching for Bray. And now this week, Bray was searching for Randy, then got locked in this container and it was, I don't know, I like it.
Yeah, it was alright. It was horror movie-esque. But I think him just kind of, teleporting out the thing was a bit much. to keep the supernatural stuff out of it. But other than that, I thought it was cool.
It's like, it's a part of me that is secretly into it a little bit.
Yeah, me too. But there's part of me that's super into like Matt Hardy and stuff as well. But
yeah,
I repressed that.
But do you think we're going to see Sister Abigail at some point?
I hope so.
I do think we're going to now.
I think so. As long as they don't, like, make us some sort of undead wizard gimmick. I don't know. Yeah. It's weird.
It is weird, but,
because the Undertaker is the only undead wizard that's allowed in WWE. He's great.
I know, but... It's television, it's professional wrestling, it's crazy, so we'll just
shrug. Yeah,
we'll just shrug and let it carry on, yeah.
Yeah.
If somebody watched it, right, out of context, right, like, yeah, what the hell is this?
Is this a sport? What's going on?
Why is this on Sky Sports?
Yeah.
What is this? Why is that guy just disappeared out of a storage container, and who the hell is Sister Abigail?
It's bizarre, but we love it.
It is, but it'll be fine. I mean, I'm looking forward to the match on Sunday at No Mercy.
Yeah, it'll be good. We hope Bray wins.
Me too.
So yeah,
other than that, I think he will.
Yeah,
but we'll talk about that in a little while
for sure. So the mystical looking Miss TV Dolphumentary going through like Dolph's start as Kerwin White's caddy to the Spirit Squad and to where he is now.
Yeah, it was really good. It was like done in sort of WWE 24 documentary style, which I really really liked. I thought it was really cool.
It was cool. But yeah, and turns out two members of the Spirit Squad turned up to help out the Miz and just try and, like, I don't know, cheer up Dolph, I guess. But even though they ended up beating him up, and I don't know, it was a thing.
It was interesting to see Kenny Dykstra there, actually.
Yeah, it's a bit weird.
Because, and he's still in phenomenal shape, too, yeah. Kenny is. Because Kenny wrestled after the Spirit Squad, like, and was doing all right, and then just sort of vanished. Get him back. I like Kenny. He's fine.
Yeah, he's all right.
The other one I've gone, I know who the Spirit Squad are. But I don't know who most of them are apart from Dolph Ziggler and Kenny Dykstra.
Yeah, seriously.
But get Kenny back, get rid of that other guy, that's fine.
Yeah, who the other guy's aged horribly. Poor guy.
Yeah.
But yeah, it was a good segment, I thought. And, you know, it's like Dolph's last chance to get sight, otherwise he's gone.
Yeah, I think, and again, we talk the Miz up every single week here, but both of these guys have done phenomenal work on the microphone these last few weeks, hyping their feud up and hyping sort of Dolph's shortcomings and that sort of thing. And I think it's brought the best out in both of them.
Yeah.
In both the Miz and Dolph.
I agree. I think both should get some sort of main event push after this because they're both amazing. I don't think Dolph's leaving. No way.
See, I have a different opinion.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I will get to that in No Mercy predictions. But, yeah. It's a cool feud they've got going and I'm a big fan. What else happened? Cole Hawkins is debuting at No Mercy. Looking forward to that. That'd be cool.
Yep. I really do love his vignettes. They're stupid and funny at the same time.
Yeah, they're cool.
I don't know who he's going to fight at No Mercy, but I like that they're saving him for No Mercy. I think that's good.
Yeah, I do.
It's like they do with NXT. If somebody's debuting, like Kevin Owens' example.
Yeah.
And Shinsuke Nakamura. Not in the same league, of course, but, you know, they're saving them for the pay-per-view like it's a big deal. I think that's a good thing.
Yeah. Good times. Swagger and Corbin had a weird match.
Sure.
Corbin got the reason for the ropes, looked like he was tapping out, and then the ref called the match, and then Corbin freaked out and broke stuff.
I'm fine with the feud. I really am. Right? But it has to go somewhere.
Yeah. It won't.
But one of these two, if whoever wins it, they have to go for the IC title.
Yeah, I guess. They don't have the match at No Mercy, are they? And this gets added on the pre-show, doesn't it?
Yeah, I think it probably will.
Yeah.
It means we have to play as them on the game as well.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
There's a few characters.
There's
a few characters that are getting used recently. Like Heath Slater, he has not made an appearance on any of the streams until Backlash.
Yeah.
And this will be Jack Swagger's first appearance, probably since the Royal Rumble.
Probably, yeah. That's pretty much it. It's a women's tag match with Bumwiggle and Pigtails versus the other ones.
Yeah, it was originally a singles match between Nikki and Alexa Bliss.
Oh, yeah.
In typical SmackDown fashion, during the ad break, it was made into a, like, it cut off, like, when everyone was brawling in the ring.
Yeah.
Comes back and...
Tag match.
There's one woman, sorry, two women on the apron, two women fighting in the ring. Oh, it's a tag team match. Oh, yeah. Right, great.
Typical SmackDown.
Yeah. And I think even JBL even said, like, Daniel Bryan channeled his inner Teddy Long.
Oh, yeah, he did.
And then, of course, AJ Styles, Dean Ambrose and Cena had a great segment at the end.
Yes, it was a great match. Not match, but segment.
Really, really good.
They kept interrupting Cena, not letting him talk.
Yeah.
It's good. I think they're building a good feud between Ambrose and Cena going forwards.
Yeah. I've been loving this. I have to be honest. I really have. I've been loving AJ's heel work against Cena, and you know he's been doing a really good job against Ambrose too.
Yep.
Dean Ambrose has really surprised me with how good he's been.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm a Dean Ambrose fan anyway, but he's really surprised me with how just into this he's sort of become.
Yeah.
So like he's just really gone all in on Cena, and then I think, but that sort of thing brings out the best in Cena as well.
It does. I agree.
So the three of them together. Usually these triple threat things seem just sort of chucked together in what, just, you know, just go and have a match and we'll get rid of one of you and, you know, you will, you know, then two of you will go off and have a feud, blah, blah, blah. Yeah. But, you know, this seems like they've built it properly. They've given it time to grow and, it's been brilliant. Really good. I'm excited to, I'm actually really excited for that match at No Mercy. I think it's going to be great.
Yeah, me too. So excited. Yeah, speaking of No Mercy, let's go through our predictions.
Let's.
Right, so the first match we've got on here is Kurt Hawkins' debut versus whoever the fuck.
Well, you would imagine he will win.
Yeah, he's got it, surely.
Depending on what sort of character they're going to try and build for him, because it could be one of those things where he comes in, big debut, and then loses, but I doubt that very highly. I imagine Kurt Hawkins will walk away with the W.
Yeah, same. I can't see him losing. Do you want to put Baron Corbin versus thingy on there?
We'll put it on there just in case. Yeah. I think if they're going to do it, something similar will happen to what happened on SmackDown. Opposite results, so Baron Corbin will win.
Yeah, you're probably right. I'm going to take Corbin as well because he's the better out of the two and deserves to push more, in my opinion.
Fair enough.
But yeah,
we don't know if that's going to happen on there. We'll just put it on there for the sake of it.
Yeah, but why not? Yeah, next one I've got on here is Nikki Bella versus Carmella. Interesting one. Hard to know what's going to happen in this one.
It is. Nikki hasn't won a lot since she's come back.
She hasn't.
But they seem to be really hyping and pushing Carmella at the minute.
Yeah, she's one of the last people in the last elimination match. Women's match.
I imagine the winner of this match will be the next in line for a championship match.
Yeah, probably.
So I'm going to say Carmella's going to win because she's the heel.
Good point. I want to say Nikki, just because, as you said, she hasn't really won an awful lot since coming back, and she's like a fan favourite, and just be like a good feel-good moment, and maybe she can go for the title. Maybe there'll be like a triple threat match for the title next time.
Maybe.
And I'll throw in there. I'm going to say Nikki.
Okay.
Good old Bumwiggle.
Yeah. Oh, the Bumwiggle.
Big fan of the Bumwiggle. Next up, we've got Heath and Rhino versus the Usos for the Tag Team Championship.
This is an interesting one.
It is.
Because the Usos are featured more prominently on TV at the minute than Heath and Rhino, and Heath and Rhino are the champions.
That's true.
And they're also in a massive feud with American Alpha, which they also had this week on SmackDown. Mm-hmm. So Heath has won the tag team titles and he's got his contract.
Yes.
Do they take the belts off them now?
I don't know. The Usos need some momentum going forward, I think, because they cement them as like top heels. So I'm going to say the Usos are going to win this.
Yeah, I think so.
And also gives American Alpha something to chase for as well.
Yeah, I do think the Usos are going to win. I think the tag team title thing was just to set Heath up.
Yeah, pretty much. I think Rhino will turn heel doing this as well.
Turn on Heath?
Think so.
Maybe.
Just have another big meaty heel there.
Yeah, I think so. And also they can sort of, they can push super face Heath against heel Rhino, especially if Rhino does turn on him.
True.
Because, you know, he's been carrying the team, so
yeah.
He seems to like win every match for them.
Yeah.
So if Heath loses, I don't know. I do think the Usos are going to win. I think it's right for the Usos to win.
Yeah.
Because if they lose twice on pay-per-view to Heath and Rhino in a row,
you didn't look great.
This doesn't really look good for your super heel tag team.
Yeah, it doesn't. Right. After that, we've got Miz versus Dolph for the IC title. I'm going to say Miz in this one because I already threw it away what I'm going to say, but just because I've got, oh, no, not Miz. Fucking Jesus Christ. I'm going to say Dolph in this one because I can't see Miz, Jesus Christ. Can't see Dolph leaving the company just yet.
I think Miz is going to win.
Okay.
I think there's a reason for this storyline, and I think Dolph is going to go off and do something else for a little while before coming back and being repackaged in some sort of way.
Interesting.
Now, the rumour that I did hear is that we're going to sort of repackage him in some sort of varsity storyline.
Right.
Like, former, you know, like university grads. So when Shelton Benjamin is ready to come back, package him with him. And there was somebody else mentioned as well, but I can't quite remember who it was. So that's a thing that I think might happen. Ziggler might go sort of pursue other interests in the meantime, take a bit of a break, which in my opinion he needs, because at the minute nobody's rooting for Ziggler. Like, I'm not. I couldn't care less if he wins on Sunday or loses or what, because I think the Miz is just going so strong. It's end that title run now. You just can't.
Something Tyrone said, I think, during yesterday's stream, is that he thought Dolph might win via DQ. That way, Miz keeps the title and Dolph keeps his job. Interesting, interesting idea.
It is, and it is an interesting idea, but I just don't see it. I think Miz will win by cheating, and we won't see Dolph for a little while.
Interesting. Okay. Interesting. So next we've got Becky Lynch versus Alexa Bliss for the SmackDown's women title.
It's too early to take the belt from Becky just yet, I think.
Yeah, I agree. I think Alexa will definitely be champion one day, but not yet.
I think the SmackDown women's division, although it got off to a really sort of rocky start, I think it has incredible potential.
Oh, yeah.
Because Carmella seems to be improving every week in the ring. Mm-hmm. Alexa is already great. Nikki is so great. You know, Naomi's already just a super athlete.
Yeah, she's incredible. Yeah, and she's very popular with people as well.
Yep. So there's a wealth of talent. Natalia is obviously great. You've got Eva Marie to come back, who does have all the potential in the world.
Yeah,
just needs to
learn how to wrestle.
Just behave herself.
Yeah, don't do
just
drugs.
Just knuckle down and just crack on with it.
Yeah.
I think Paige would benefit going to SmackDown, in truth.
Yeah, but it won't.
But she was too high a pick on Raw to...
yeah, that's a good point.
To go to SmackDown just yet.
If she comes back at all.
She will.
Yeah, I hope she does. Next up, I've got Randy Orton versus Bray Wyatt.
I think Bray Wyatt's going to win. I think we might see the first appearance of Sister Abigail at No Mercy. And it's going to be a big deal. But I think this feud will carry on, because I think it's got legs. I don't think it finishes at No Mercy. I think it goes beyond that. Yeah. And I'm fine with it, because it keeps Randy Orton away from the championship.
True.
But it also keeps him in an interesting storyline, because I do think this is great.
I'm
really, really enjoying it. But I think Bray wins. I think he needs it.
Yeah, hard to say.
Because Eric Rowan's out now. I don't know if you've seen that, but Eric Rowan's out for like 3 to 4 months.
Oh, he is? Oh.
So he's not got Eric Rowan to sort of watch his back.
Yeah, so that's a shame.
I think Bray needs a solid win, but I think some help from Sister Abigail will be... I think we'll see Sister Abigail this weekend.
Cool. I did hear that Luke Harper is back fit and ready to go. So I think we'll see him at No Mercy as well.
Maybe. If he's going to SmackDown.
Yeah, that's true. If he's going to SmackDown.
It would make sense now with Eric Rowan being out.
Yeah, yeah.
We'll see. I mean, I'm really excited for Luke Harper to come back. So
he's
awesome.
He's so good, yeah.
It's been ages as well.
Yeah, it has, yeah. Ooh, who do I pick? Bray doesn't win. I'm going to pick Randy. Just because Bray doesn't win matches. Sadly. But I do think we'll see something. Something will happen. Maybe they'll lose by DQ or something.
Yeah, I mean, we'll either see Sister Abigail, which I think might happen because they alluded to it on SmackDown.
Yeah, yeah.
Or we might see Luke Harper come back.
Okay, if you do see him, who do you think it's going to be? Do you think it's going to be someone from NXT or someone new?
It can't be somebody from NXT.
Okay.
It can't be, because otherwise that's stupid.
Maybe.
Somebody from NXT can't be. It could be his actual sister.
Did he have a sister?
Because I think their sister is a wrestler as well. I don't quote me on that, because I don't 100% know. But I think the sister in the Rotunda family is a wrestler as well, but I'm not sure. Not 100% at least.
Interesting.
So they could bring her in if she is... Well, she doesn't need to be a wrestler, I guess.
Yeah, I guess not. Gets to be like a ringside person like Lana or something.
I doubt very highly she'll look like Lana though.
Yeah, probably not. Yeah, the only match left is the main event. AJ versus Dean versus John Cena, etc.
Okay. So I think AJ keeps hold of the title.
Yeah.
And I think somehow this leads to Cena versus Dean Ambrose feud going forward, which I'm, and then one of them will eventually get a title shot, and Cena will win that championship without question.
Oh yeah.
Probably the Royal Rumble. I'm gonna keep hold of that now.
Good prediction.
Mm-hmm. But AJ's gonna keep the belt. And I think he's gonna go over Ambrose.
Interesting. Okay. Yeah, I can say pretty much the same thing. I think Cena and Ambrose are gonna get into it, and they're gonna be so focused on each other that AJ kind of sneaks in and wins the match, either by roll up or just gets him with a forearm or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, AJ's not gonna lose just yet.
No.
And, yeah, I'll definitely see, Ambrose and Cena feuding going forwards, and I think Ambrose is due for a heel turn. So that'd be great.
Yeah, that's got a lot of potential as well, I think.
Yeah, yeah.
I think that could be really good, but the pay-per-view itself is shaping up really nicely, and I'm looking forward to it.
Look forward to pretty much all the matches on there.
Yeah.
It'd be great.
This is a good thing.
It's very good.
Like, we looked forward to Clash of Champions.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't maybe deliver on all of our expectations, but it was fine.
Yes, man.
But this, I mean, SmackDown is really good at the minute, so I'm excited for it.
Yeah, I'm excited.
This Sunday on YouTube around 7:30-ish,
yep,
you can join us for our WWE 2K16 No Mercy Prediction Show.
For the last time ever.
Yep, this is going to be the last one on WWE 2K16. The next one will be Hell in a Cell on WWE 2K17,
woo,
which is going to be awesome. So that's this coming Sunday.
Awesome.
Next Tuesday, if you join us for WWE 2K17 live stream on YouTube.
Yep, yep.
We'll be going through what we think about it, you know, playing some matches, flicking through the modes, that sort of stuff.
Yeah.
And having a general conversation about it also. Next week, we're going to record the podcast a day later. That shouldn't really affect the day it comes out, so it should still hit on Friday. But you can join us next Thursday on YouTube for some PlayStation VR stuff.
So excited.
It's going to be great.
So excited. Can't even.
Yeah, I can't even either. So it's going to be good. But there'll be streams in between now and then, so yeah, look out for those.
Yep.
Definitely. In the meantime, subscribe to our podcast on iTunes, follow us on SoundCloud, and subscribe to our channel on YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
You can also find our podcast anywhere.
Yes, yes.
Well, we are the Sydney Finn Show, and we are a weekly wrestling and video game podcast that posts every single Friday across all the aforementioned platforms.
Whether you like it or not.
Yes. But this has been episode 33.
Has.
I'm Sunny.
I'm Finn.
And thank you for listening, and we'll speak to you next time. Goodbye.
Thanks so much. Goodbye.